What is test end-to-end in the context of the Safe for DevOps Health Radar? Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is a framework. Use it as a toolbox. Take out what fits your needs or what solves your problem. In my previous videos, we talked about how big ideas are coming from customer side, but also from the business side, and get transferred into epics with a clear hypothesis statement. After that, we are going into collaborate and research, where we are going to analyze the epics together with the customer. We do interviews with the customer and we are doing market research. Then we go with this epic into architect. We are defining the minimal architecture to prove the hypothesis. After that, we are going into synthesize, where we are going to break down this epic into features and creating a roadmap and a vision. And then in develop, we start to break down the features into user stories, and we are going to develop these user stories. Then we are committing the source code into the version control system, and the build server integrates the source code with the rest of the code. He compiles it and does the unit testing. The output of the build step is a deployable artifact, which we are now going to test end-to-end. In the test end-to-end step, we are going to validate the solution against the acceptance criteria in a production-like environment. In the build step, we have executed the unit and component tests. Now, in the test end-to-end step, it is required that we are doing the tests on a feature level, which are system level or integration tests. To do the integration tests, it is required to have an environment which is as near as possible to the production system so that we can reliably execute the tests and rely on the test results. And please also remember that everything needs to be under version control, also the configurations of the test environments. In order to execute the tests in a test environment, we need to have test data. We have already talked about test data. We talked about test data already in the architect step, where we said that we need to architect the system so that it is testable. And then we created the test data in the develop step. It is essential that we use for testing synthetic production-like test data. In many projects, I see that people are using production data for testing or anonymized production data. This is possible to do, but it is not recommended to do, because when you are using production data, you get flaky tests, because that test data that is in there can always change or be removed. And the last thing you want to have is a flaky test, because a flaky test has zero value for you. And also, all of your test data needs to be stored in version control. Usually, you have a system that depends on other systems. You have interfaces to these other systems. In order to move fast, you need to be decoupled from this system and you need to be able to test decoupled from these systems. To do that, we use service virtualization. So we create simulators for these systems so that we can test independently of the release cycles of the other systems. This has the big benefit that we can use the test data, the synthetic test data that we have created, also for the other systems, because we have now the simulators and we can enrich these simulators with the correct synthetic test data. And again, also these service virtualizations or these simulators needs to be maintained under version control. We not only need to do the functional testing, but we also need to do non-functional testing. We talked already about the non-functional requirements in the architect step in this video that you can see here above. Non-functional requirements are system attributes like security, reliability, performance, maintainability, scalability, usability. These are the utilities of our system. Important is a non-functional requirement is not a backlog item, it's not a user story, it's not a feature, it's a non-functional requirement, and this is a constraint on our backlog. It applies to all backlog items. We talked already about test automation in the develop step, which you can see in this video here. In this video, we talked about the unit and component testing, which is only part of the test automation. To get a clearer picture on the test automation, I have brought you this agile test matrix, which you can see over here. First of all, we have the area Q1 below there, which is blue. In there, you have the unit and the component tests, which we already discussed in this video up here. They can easily be automated. In this area, we use test-driven development. When we are moving up in the agile test matrix, we are going into the area Q2, where we are going to execute all of the functional tests. This area is also called the user acceptance test, because in this area we are going to execute the acceptance tests, which have been defined in the features and in the user stories. As also mentioned in this video here, we are going to use behavior-driven development to do that, so that we have a good set of acceptance criteria. The acceptance tests in this area are executed preferably automated. Now we are moving left into the area Q3 in the agile test matrix. In this area, we are executing system level acceptance tests. There, we want to validate the behavior of the whole system, and this also includes other systems. Therefore, we use their exploratory testing or workflow testing. In this area, automation is hard, and especially maintaining these tests is quite expensive. So here we usually have a lot of manual tests. Next, we move down into the area Q4, where we are going to execute all of the non-functional tests. Here we take the non-functional requirements which we have defined and which are constrained on the backlog, and we are going to execute non-functional requirements tests against our system. In this area, we have quite a lot of tools which we can use to execute all of these non-functional requirements tests. There are specialized tools for security, there are specialized tools for performance testing. Because of the tool support, it is easy to automate these non-functional requirements tests, and therefore we again have here a high degree of automation. The output of the test end-to-end step is that we have a verified solution. So we have executed the functional test, the integration test, the regression test, the performance test, and also the exploratory testing. And we have got a test evidence, which is usually needed when we are in a regulated environment. There is a broad tool support when it comes to testing. You can see again here the periodic table of DevOps tools, and you'd see down here all of the common tests tools that you can use to verify your solution. The Safe for DevOps Health Radar is an assessment. You can download the Excel to this assessment with this link here, and with that you can assess yourself in test end-to-end. Testing involves validating feature-level functionality in production-like environments. End-to-end testing typically includes functional testing, integration testing, regression testing, performance testing, and exploratory testing. Rate your team's effectiveness at testing continuously end-to-end in production-like environments. You are a SIT when testing is performed manually in environments that do not mimic production. Testing occurs in large batches during a scheduled testing phase. You are a crawl when testing is mostly manual in non-production-like environments. Stories are implemented and tested independently within a single PI, which is a 3-month cycle. You are walk when half the testing is automated and performed in production-like or production-simulated environments every PI, which is a 3-month cycle. You are a run when the majority of tests are automated and run in production-like environments. Stories are implemented and fully tested every iteration. An iteration is a sprint, so it's a 2-week cycle. You are fly when successful builds trigger automatic deployments to production-like test environments. All tests are automated. Tests run in parallel and changes are fully validated after every commit. Testing end-to-end means that we are going to validate our system end-to-end in a production-like environment, which includes functional testing but also non-functional testing. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because I will create a video every week for you.